befell that in that season on a day in Sadoc at the table as I lay ready to end on my pilgrimage to Canterbury with full devout courage. At night they came into that hostelry where 29 in a company of sundry folk were chanced to bear a plan in fellowship, and pilgrims were they all. That what Canterbury would ride. The chambers and the stables were wide, and where we were lodged at the best, and shortly when the sun was come to rest, so had I spoken with them everyone, that I was of their fellowship anon, and made agreement early for to rise to tell. Nonetheless, while I have time and space, ere that I further in this story pace, methinketh it according to reason to tell you all the condition of each of them, so as it seemed me, and which they were, and of what degree, and eke of what array that they were in. And at the night bed will I first begin. Thank you.
some young squire, a lover and a lusty bachelor, with locks a curl, as they were laid in press. For 20 years of age he was, I guess. Of his stature he was an even length, and wonderly active, and great of strength. And he had been sometime in cavalry, in Flanders, in Artois, and in Brittany, and won him well, and in so short a space, in hope of favor by his lady's grace. Of hooting all the day, he was as fresh as is the month of May. Short was his gown, his sleeves long and white. Well could he sit on horse and fly and ride. He would have made swords and would invite joust and reapers and well put fair and right. So hot he loved, so hot.
Fingers in her sauces. likely to be master, a bold rider that loved hunting.
Thank you. and a carpenter, a weaver, a dyer, and a tapestry maker, and they were clothed all in one livery.
Oh! sergeant of the law. Wary and wise. There was also
daisy. Of his complexion he was sanguine, well loved in the morning, a sop in wine. will live in delight, whosoever his bones, for he was Epicurus' own son, that held opinion that full delight was verily felicity. Great was he, open to all that came in his country. His bread, his ale, was always of the best, a better salad man was nowhere none. Without baked meat was never his house, of fish and flesh and that so plenteous. It's not in his house of meat and drink. Of every day did that man could feed. After the sundry seasons of the year, so changed he his meat and his supper. For many a fat partridge had he in coop, and many a bream, and many a loosing stew. Oh, was his cook, if his sauces were not poignant and sharp, and ready for his gear, his table fixed in the hallway, stood ready covered all the livelong day. At sessions there he was lord and sire, took off times he was knight of the shire, a cutlass and a pouch all silk. And his girdle white as morning egg. A sheriff had he been, and a naughty tongue.
was a doctor of physic. In all this world there was none to him like, to speak of physic and surgery. Of every malady, were it of hot or cold or moist or dry, and when they engendered, and of what humor, he was a very perfect practiser. The cause known, and of its harm the root, anon he gave us in man. Full ready had he his apothecaries to send him drugs and his electuars, for each of them made all the for to win. Perfection was the new thing to begin. Hippocrates, Hardy, and Galen, Averroes, John of Damascus, and Constantine. His study was but little on the Bible, of his diet moderate was he, for it was of no superfluity, but of great nourishing and digestion. Special.
Thank you.
at hostelry and like great cheer made of host as everyone, and to the supper served he us anon, and served us with victual of the best. Strong was the wine, and well to drink us
we were seen in at a host was beyond, for to have been a marshal in a home last man he was thrice, thrice a fairer virgin's
gold. Oh, and our children eyes a prayer adores, and your blood put in that bright gold, he was who in your strength buried, and of the sun about to speak on the earth and send us.
The lordlings truly, he be to me right welcome heartily, for by my troth, if that I shall not lie, I have not seen this year so merry a company. Fain would I make you mirth, wist I how, and of a plan I am now right bethought. We go to Canterbury, God you speed, a blissful martyr quit you your mean. And well I want, as ye go by the way, ye set yourself to tell tales and to jest, for truly comfort and mirth there is none to ride by the way, dumb as a stone. And therefore will I make to you disport, and if you like it all by one assent, now for to stand at my judgment. Tomorrow, when ye ride by the way, be ye not merry, spite of my head. This is the point, to speak it short and plain, at each of you, to shorten you the way, in this voyage shall tell tales twain, of adventures that once had befallen, and which of you bear the best of all, shall have a supper.
Thank you.
let's see now who shall tell the first tale. As ever I may drink wine or ale, whoso is rebel to my judgment shall pay for all that by the way is spent. Now to the locks, ere that we farther wend, he that hath the shortest shall begin. So light, my master, study not, lay hand to it, every man.
Since I shall begin again.